They fought each other.
Yeah, Shane Mosley, Six Ass Lewis, Joe Gatti, who else? Arcelino Freitas. I mean, is that far?
That's amazing. How hard does Shane Mosley hit? Because everybody tells me he's the hardest hitting puncher they ever sparred.
All right, so Shane Mosley hit me, and like I got a crook in my neck. Then this was maybe a couple weeks into camp. He hit me again, and actually, like my rib was displaced. And this was getting ready for the Peterson fight. My manager at the time, everybody was like, "Nah, you shouldn't fight. All right, you're already coming off the shoulder surgery, and now you got this rib injury." And I'm just like, I can't, I was in a bad spot financially. So I'm just like, nah, I can't call it off. I got to go through with it. This whole camp, if I don't go through with this, this whole camp cost me $25,000-$30,000. And, I'm already money getting low. So now I got to go through with it. But hey, Shane Mosley, super fast, hit super fucking hard. And Zab Judah, this Zab Judah 2003, Zab hit me with an uppercut. Shit, I thought my trainer said he thought my head was about to come off. So, like I said, I'm no stranger to being in there with the best, being hit hard by the best. That doesn't faze me.
Okay, check this out. November 28th, Mike Tyson, Roy Jones. You know both of them. They're both icons. What do you think happens?
Mike Tyson got me knocked down in my rematch fight. The first knockdown. I contribute that to Mike Tyson because I'm in a ring, I'm getting comfortable. It's celebrities everywhere. Zab Judah, Mike Tyson, Paris Hilton, some other people with a star studded baby. So I looked to my left, I said, "Oh shit, that's Mike Tyson." I threw the lazy jab, the Carl Torres came over top of it, I goes down. So Roy Jones, my favorite fighter of all times. He helped me out one time. He worked in my corner back in, 2012. ESPN, my favorite fighter of all time. I want both guys to come out safe and with the health intact.
Is there anyone you ever wanted to fight in your era that it didn't happen?
In my era?
Yeah.
The champions. All right, so and like everybody I fought once I crossed over to fight in top 10 competition, everybody I fought was in the top five. Like everybody. Like so, I didn't have a specific person I wanted to fight. I just wanted to win championship belts.
You know, it's crazy. You mentioned Ricardo Torres. He was 33-2 with 29 knockouts. And you gave him, you and Cotto are the only two to beat him.
I was on that undercard, that was in Atlantic City. And yeah. I'm looking at this shit like, holy shit, this guy is fucking Cotto up. Like, what? Like, because they were trying to, after that fight, I was supposed, like, they were trying to match me against Cotto. HBO KO'd it, or HBO said no or something, because after that fight, I think Cotto and had broke his nose. I mean, Carl Torres had broken his nose or something. But another funny story, man, Cotto was supposed to fight once in the amateurs and once in the pros, but it never happened.
So last thing, you fought Ricardo Torres twice. The first time, obviously, he won. The second time, you won. How were you able to come back from being TKO to beat the guy that beat you? How did you get the mental strength to say, no, I got this?
You know what it was? It was a tremendous fucking camp. For the rest of my fights too, but I just started camp early, like just a lot of strength and conditioning, and I just kept playing that fight over and over in my head. Like the first fight, like I felt like I was winning so easy, the lights was on in the arena, and it didn't feel like a championship fight. But after that whole fiasco that happened over there, I was just determined to win. Like, and when I went down, I jumped right up. I wasn't hurt. It was a flash knockdown. And then I was just like, it's too early for this shit. The first round was too early. Then the second time, I was trying to hold him and he was punching. I kind of slipped and went down. And then when I got up, he hit me with the left hook. That right there pissed me off. Because if you beat me, you beat me.
right, there you have it, Kendall Holt. Make sure everyone follow him on Twitter. Sorry, yeah, you on Twitter too?
Yeah, I'm on Twitter and Instagram, Kendall Holt 456.
Kendall Holt 4. Is that the area code of Patterson, New Jersey?
Nah, that's CeeLo, man. That's dice game we play over here on East Coast.
Why do you have a dice game in your handle? Are you an expert? Are you a world champion?
And if you roll 4, 5, 6, you automatically win. So, I don't know. It just fit.
Usually people put their weight class, like John Molina, 135. They put their they put the year they were born, or it's the first time I ever heard. You should do, hey, you should put a tournament, and you should call out all the other boxing champions to come play you 4, 5, 6 and see if you could win another belt. So there you have it. Kendall Holt, Twitter, Instagram. Make sure Holt Boxing to get your boxing gloves. Give him a shot. Support him. See what you could do, and you won't regret it. So there you have it. Stay tuned for YouSnoopReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Secback. You can follow me on Instagram @EllieSecback.